to the Auburn side of the Vineyard Church. My name's Chris, and together with the band for these about 15 to 20 minutes of singing, we just believe that singing brings us closer to God. So don't we all stand for the first song, and I'll open with a prayer. God, we just come expecting you this morning. We ask you to come and just fill this place with your presence. Make yourself known to us.
My God has rescued her. You stay the same.
lifts our hands.
cry for help, my King and my God, for to you I pray. In the morning, O Lord, you hear my voice. In the morning, I lay my request before you and wait in expectation. But let all who take refuge in you be glad. Let them ever sing for joy. Spread your protection over them, that those who love your name may rejoice in you. Oh God, we are here in expectation. We love you so much, and we ask that you speak to our hearts today. Help us to learn what it is you have for us today, and help us to go out there into the world and do good things in your name, Lord. We ask for blessings upon this gathering, Lord, and we just ask for you to speak to us. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Happy New Year, everybody. It's hard to believe. I feel like it's been the New Year for a long time now, and it's only just a few days. My name is Chris Gorrell, and I'm the pastor here at the site in Auburn, and I am really glad that you're with us today. Especially if you're here for the first time, I want to extend a warm welcome to you. I'm so glad that you're here. We have a gift we'd like to give you, and it's one of those gift bags that you'll see on the screen here in a moment. There it is. So there's a maroon bag, and it's out on the other side of this wall, so grab one of those. It's just for you. It's our way of saying thanks for coming and checking us out. And when you came in, you received a program that looks like this. And inside that program are all the details about things that we have coming up. So you may want to look and check that out, and all full of next steps. So I want to highlight a couple of the things that we have in this program for you this morning. If you're here and you have not been to our vision class, this is the next step for you. So if you're even thinking that this church might be one that you would want to come to and participate in, or if you've never been to this vision class, it really is the next step in what we have for you here. And so the vision class starts the 7th. It starts this Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. This is your last opportunity to sign up for it. And John Elmer, our lead pastor in Syracuse, will be coming that Tuesday, and he'll be sharing all the information about his story, how this church got started. And then we'll look the 2 weeks after that, we'll look at our finances, how we do leadership. We kind of open the windows for you to see everything that's going on here so you know whether this is something you want to participate in. And then in your program, there is also a little brochure that looks like this. This is our small group offering for this coming quarter. So for the next 10 weeks, these are the small groups that we're offering. If you have already been to vision class, these groups are your next steps. So you'll want to check them out and sign up for one. You can see the names of the groups, where they're located. You can see whether or not they offer childcare. You can also see there who the leader is, and there's another line of those out there with pictures on the back wall, right over the coffee. So go out and check that out and see if there's one that interests you. Those will be starting not this week, but the following week, the week of the 12th. And last, I want to tell you that we are offering a prayer training. So this training is for anybody who really wonders, how do I pray for my friends? How do I pray for my family? How do I pray for my coworkers? What's a way that I can do this and not seem weird? So if you want to find out how to pray for people, come to this training. It's a Friday evening and a Saturday morning, and I think it's the 18th. In the program, it'll be listed there. Yep, 17th and 18th, so Friday evening and Saturday morning. So that is it for the things that I want to highlight from our program. And right now, I'd like you to look inside that program and find something that looks like this. This is our connection card. It's a tool that we use to serve you better. So if you want to pull this out and fill this out, I'd like to ask everybody to do that. And if you're here for the first or second time, you'll want to check off whether you're here for the first or second time, because I have a gift I want to put in the mail for you.
I have a video.
On the back of this connection card are all kinds of things that you can sign up for. You can ask for prayer. You can also put in questions or comments you have and sign up for small groups. So take a few minutes and get these filled out, and then we'll get started. Thanks. Okay, thanks for taking the time to fill those out for me. You can put them in the seat in front of you. In the back of that seat, there's a little pocket. So just stick them there, and we'll engage them later on in the service. You guys, most of you know, and we are a multi-site church, which means we are one church in different locations. And so the Auburn site is part of this multitude of churches that are starting. And so this morning, there's a church that's meeting in Cicero. There are several services in Syracuse, and there's a meeting here in Auburn. And next week, the one at the University of Syracuse starts again. And so we're glad to be part of that. And our lead pastor is John Elmer, and he's going to be speaking live with us through the video. And so just sit back, engage, and enjoy, and I'll talk with you afterwards.
Glad you joined us today. Happy New Year. A few years ago, a story came out of the slums of São Paulo, Brazil. And it was about a community who lived on a garbage dump. You know, they came in from the country, they were squatters, and that was, you know, a free spot they could stay, and they used the dump to dig through and get food, and